Beach, Wildflower Alley. I've got a photograph as it was. Mm-hmm. I'll describe it to the viewers at home. I'll try and do it in one word. Derelict. It's been completely transformed. Tell me about the history and what you've been doing.
We live in an area that's mainly HMOs, houses of multiple occupancy, which has displaced the local population, people who live here year-round. So around about 2008, 2009, we decided to lobby against all kinds of antisocial behaviour and dumping. 2010, we formed...
Antisocial behaviour being...
Houses, cars being wrecked, drunkenness on the streets, rowdiness all the time, major disturbance to residents.
Right.
And a lot of criminal behaviour, and drug dealing, prostitution, all that kind of thing.
Right.
So in 2010, we formed an Alleygate group and we lobbied to get these Alleygates that you can see. Mm-hmm. So here we had then, once we had the Alleygates and everybody has their key, all this reclaimed urban space. It looked like that. Mm. We had the drug dealing there, we had the prostitution, we had dumping, major, major dumping. So we as residents just got together, cleared tons of rubbish and began to put out plants. It's called Wildflower Alley because our first donation was from Grow Wild Wildflowers. Our second donation was from Queen's University, who gave us compost. Then once we, the residents, had started this, it's strange how success breeds success. The statutory agencies didn't want to help at first. Once we did it ourselves, they came in.
That's okay. Sometimes you have to lead and they follow.
We led, they followed.
Just never say I told you so.
That was good. No, it worked wonderfully. And now we have this beautiful, usable space that you can see that's good for all our health, that has attracted wildlife, bees, birds, has helped everybody health-wise, and also to deal with all the issues that I have identified around us of antisocial behaviour and so on. Well, there's two words people use when they leave. One is inspired and the other is wow.